So yesterday we saw global and Indian scenario on floriculture, and we saw recent developments in marketing of cut flowers. Then we saw steps taken by the government of India to ease the export of flowers. Then we saw few schemes for financial aid in terms of floriculture. And then we went through rose, chrysanthemum, carnation and gladiolus. Today we'll see other major cut flowers like Anthurium, Jarbera, Orchid, Lilium, Astromeria and Dahlia. Then we'll see some loose flowers like Marigold, Jasmine, Chrysanthemum, Tuberose and Chinaster. Like I mentioned yesterday, whenever you are reading any crop, first thing you must remember four things, that is scientific name, its common name, if any. Like in case of Jarbera, it is also called as transfer daisy, or Astromeria is also called as Peruvian lily. Like this kind of common name, if it is there, you must remember. Then other thing is family and chromosome number. You must remember chromosome number, because sometimes there will be direct questions from the chromosome number, or like example, like it could be, what is the basic chromosome number of rose? It is 7, right? Then other thing is, if you know the basic chromosome number, it will be easier for you to remember if there is any polyploid varieties or species in that particular crop. Then there will be at least one or two questions, or sometimes even more questions, from planting time, planting density, pruning time, temperatures, etc. And you don't want to miss those questions, because those are the direct questions. So sometimes even from soil pH also. So today what I have done is, I have tried to mention this in PPT, but even if I tell it now, it's impossible, or it may not be possible for you all to remember now. So I'll forward this PPT to everyone, and please go through it whenever you get time. And today we'll just discuss about all the important points. Is that okay? Me, right? Okay. So I'll forward, then you can go through those PPTs whenever you get time, okay? And I'm sorry, yesterday I couldn't take up any questions. So today, if time permits, then I'll take some questions as well. So now, first we'll go through Anthurium. Anthurium, it is a tropical flower. Out here you can see, this is the spathe. This is called spathe, and this is called spadix, and it is also called as candle. And the true flowers, it's present in the spadix. And the flower will be bisexual. And this is mostly a tropical flower, and it belongs to family Ericaceae. It requires shade, or otherwise it will have a burning, the spathe will be burned out. So it requires a shade of 75% to 80%. This is again very important. And it requires relative humidity of 80%. And as I said, this is a tropical flower, so its temperature requirement is 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. It's quite higher than other crops, and the fruit is called berry. This occurring is one of the important practices that is practiced in Anthurium. This occurring, it is done to maintain the plant density, and also to provide the good aeration. And its commercial lifespan is 6 to 8 years. After 6 to 8 years, you need to change the planting material, or you can go for a new plantation. And as I said, the true flower is present in the spadix, and here the flower is protogynous. Protogynous means the male, the female flowers mature earlier than the male flower. And acropetal succession means it opens from downside to upward. And this is also called as candle, as I said earlier. And there's one variegated species that has the variegated foliage. It is the Anthurium grande. It was asked during my IR exam. And one very important thing thing to remember, like to check the quality of the anthurium flower is the angle between the spadix and the spathe, and it should be around 45 degrees. And there are some diploid, triploid, and tetraploid species. SRF aspirants can go through it. And important disease is anthracnose, which is called by Colitrotrichum grisperoides. And there's one IHR hybrid, IHR 151, that is resistant to anthracnose. And bacterial blight is caused by the Anthomonas campestris, former species Diphenbachii. And Julia and Gemini are two important varieties that are resistant to bacterial blight. Harvesting is done when one part of the spadix is fully open. And stories, as I said, it's a tropical flower. So again, the stories is done at 13 degrees centigrade for 2 to 3 weeks. So this question has been asked many times because this stories temperature is quite higher than the normal than for the normal flowers. So please remember this nicely. And there are many varieties. You can go through later when you get the PPT. And there's one bicolor variety, that is Obig. So coming to Gerbera. Gerbera is also called as Transvaal daisy, Barbican daisy, or African daisy. Again, this has been asked many times. And this Gerbera, the term was coined by German naturalist Traugott Gerber. And there's one species, Gerbera kunziana, which is a Himalayan species. And this species, as it is resistant to low temperature, so it can be used as a source for low temperature in breeding program. And for Gerbera, reproductive phase usually starts after 16 weeks. And commercial flowers, it gives after 30 years onwards. And there are many varieties developed by IHR and even from ISBT Palampur, of which Orca krishika, it is very important. It is grown in open field condition. These are some of the varieties. And out here, even Orca rate is also recommended for growing in outside conditions. Orca ashra, this I have given just for your reference. And sometimes what they do is they even ask the flower colors. So by looking these pictures, I thought it would be easier for you to remember. So that's why I put these pictures. And Orca krishika, the yield is 400 to 425 flowers per square meter per year. Propagations, it's now for commercial propagation, it is mostly done through tissue culture. However, through division of the clumps also you can do, and which is done during March to June. And planting density, again very important, it was asked many times. Planting density should be 8 to 10 plants per square meter. And Gerbera water requirements, watering is done usually through drip irrigation, and it should be 500 to 700 ml per day. And important diseases are foot rot and root rot. You please remember its causal organisms. And one physiological disorder, this is post-harvest disorder, is this stem break, as you can see in the picture also. And premature flower wilt. And Gerbera, it has a serious problem of leaf miner. Now coming to orchid. Orchid, it is a very diverse plant. So I will try to cover as much as possible. Again, you please go through the books. Orchid, it ranks sixth in terms of cut flower, and it belongs to family Orchidaceae. And India, we have 7% of world orchid diversity. And these are some of the like number of species that is distributed in Indian conditions. Sometimes they may ask how many species are present in India and all that. You can go through it. And largest, second largest family after Asteraceae. Orchidaceae is the second largest family after Orchidaceae. And Indian species, mostly we have Dendrobia, followed by the Habenaria. This is Habenaria. And some of the species are native to India, like Aries, Arachnes. Arachnes, also known as climbing orchid or scorpion or spider orchid. Then Escocentrum, Cymbidium. Cymbidium is also called as king of orchids, and it is the temperate orchid. Dendrobium, it is a tropical orchid, and Phalaenopsis is also called as moth orchid. Paphiopedilum is called lady slippers. Rhinanthera is a sun-loving orchid. Rinko stylis is a foxtail orchid. It is also a state flower of Arunachal Pradesh. And Vanda is a climbing orchid. And largest genus is a Bulbophyllum. In orchid, we have mostly seven parts. Three sepals and three petals, and one petal is modified and becomes a column, and one gynostemum, which is also called as column, and it is a fusion of male and female parts. Then this is for your reference, some of the pictures I have put. This man-made orchid, this is called man-made orchid, which is a cross between Escocentrum and Vanda. Orchid state is called Arunachal Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, and it has more than 600 species. And we have Sesa orchid sanctuary in West Kameng district of Arunachal Pradesh. And Thailand is our largest producer and exporters of orchid in Asia, and importer is Japan. And vanilla, you must know the vanilla ice creams and all that. It is derived from Vanilla planifolia. And NRC orchid is located at Pakyong in Sikkim, and usually pollen, it is present as a waxy mass, and which is called pollinia, and fruit is called capsule. And velamen, I have shown here in the picture. Velamen, it is a layer of spongy tissue around the true root. Actually, true roots are present inside this velamen, and this velamen helps in absorption of nutrients from the air and water, and it is mostly found in the epiphytic orchid. So orchid growing was revolutionized after the Professor Louis Kunden saw the germinations of orchid seeds in the media. That is how tissue culture also started. And based on the habitat, we have epiphytic orchid and terrestrial orchid. Epiphytic orchids are mostly found in tropical zones, and most of the most common used growing media is Osmunda. And important examples are Cattleya, Dendrobium, and Phalaenopsis. And terrestrial orchids we mostly find in the temperate zones. And example is Cymbidium. This is the Cymbidium flower. And based on growing patterns, we have monopodial orchid and symbodial orchid. Monopodial orchids, we mostly propagate it through top cuttings. And in monopodial orchid, what happens is plant grows upward with new leaves produced at the tip and flowers in the axils. Axils is the angle between upper surface of the leaf and the stems. And in monopodial orchids, we do not find rhizomes and pseudobulbs. This is the pseudobulbs, and it is mostly single stem flowers, and it has the aerial roots. And examples are Phalaenopsis, Vanda, Rhinanthera, etc. Then symbodial orchid, it is mostly propagated through division. And what happens is the growth of plant will be seized after flowering, and new shoots develop every year. And here pseudobulbs, you can see here also pseudobulbs is present, and it is usually multi-stems. Pseudobulb, it is actually a modified stem, and it helps in the storage of foods and other food materials. And examples is Cymbidium, Dendrobium, etc. So based on the temperature, orchids are divided into cool orchid, intermediate orchid, and warm orchid. I have given the temperatures for that, and with the examples. You please go through it later. And propagations, we can do it through air layering or for cuttings. Cutting. Then offshoots or kikis, or through the division. And examples also have given. You go it through later. And kikis, it is here I have given the example of Dendrobium. It is the side shoots that is produced from the main plant, and we can detach these and go directly for rooting, or we can put it in rooting media and later we can transplant it again. Orchid, it is a humid loving plant, so it requires a humidity of 75 to 80%, and seeds are mostly not endospermic, and it has a symbiotic relations with the Rhizoctonia fungus, and flowers are mostly stored at 5 to 7 degrees centigrade, and major pests are snails and slugs, which can be controlled by spraying metaldehyde. And again, this is important because when we say major pest and disease and insect pest, we mostly think about thrips, aphids and all, but in case of orchid, it is the snail and slugs. And major disease is heart rot, which is caused by Phytophthora. Then there are some physiological disorders, that is dry sepal injury due to it occurs due to high humidity or smoke, and deformed flowers and browning of throat, it is due to low temperature and chilling injury. And recently NRC orchid has developed three important varieties, that is Namo, Sardar and Dindaya. And it was Namo and Sardar, it was named by our honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, so you can remember this one as well. Then tiniest orchid is Tinea phyllum carcinum, this is the picture. And largest orchid, Indian orchid, is Galeola. And other this area, which Pusilla, it is also one of the smallest orchid, and it is just around one centimeter. And Oncidium, I think I haven't mentioned it earlier, so Oncidium is also called as Dancing Lady. And bee orchid is of rare species, as it mimics bee. So these are the normal varieties, Dindaya and Sardar varieties of Cymbidium, developed from NRC orchid Sikkim. So now we'll go to Lilium. Lilium, it is a monocot plant, winter hardy and sun loving plant. And it is very susceptible to high temperature. So it is mostly grown at the subtropical climatic zones. We have major two groups, oriental groups and ascetic groups. This is the oriental and this is the ascetic. Oriental groups, it is derived from Lilium orientum speciosum and rubellum. And it is mostly late flowering and mostly fragrant. And it has a broad leaves, though I couldn't show you in the picture. It has mostly broad leaves, and balls are usually bigger than in the ascetic Lilium. Stargazer and Casablanca are the important variety. Stargazer, again, it has been asked many times. You remember, it is the variety of oriental lily. And ascetic lily, it is derived from the hybridizations of about 12 species. And flowers are mostly orderlies and leaves are narrow than in the oriental lily, and it is upward growing. In case of oriental lily, leaves are usually parallel to the ground, whereas in ascetic lily, it grows upward. And bulbs, it is 10 to 16 centimeter, that is smaller than in the oriental lily. And some of the varieties I've mentioned, you go through it. And for cut flower production, mostly Lilium longiflorum species is used. It is also called aster lily and trumpet lily. Again, these two components are important. And Lilium tigrinum, it is called a tiger lily. It is originated from Japan and it is a triplet species. And this Lilium tigrinum, then Lilium candidum, it is called Madonna lily, and it is used for essential oil extraction. And in case of Lilium, we have a major problem, that is gametophytic self-incompatibility, and it can overcome the pre-fertilization period can overcome by style grafting, and post-fertilization period can overcome by ovary slice culture, ovule culture and embryo culture. And tiara, it is a loss, it produces less pollens, because in terms of Lilium, it produces lots of pollens and that stains the table or even the cloth, so some have allergic problems with the pollens. So tiara is the variety that do not produce pollens, or it produces usually the less number of pollens. And propagation is through bulbs and bulblets and even bulbils. These are some of the species like Lilium tigrinum, Lilium candidum and Lilium diricum. These species produce bulbils. Again, bulbils, it requires 2 to 3 seasons for it to become to the bulb. And as you can see, bulbous, it is again produced at the axils. Major disorders in Presbyopium is leaf scores. It is due to the deficiency of manganese and aluminium. So blood blast is again another important disorders. It is due to the storage of water at the top of the plant, or for the competitions of the nutrients, or even in the fluctuations of carbohydrates and other nitrate levels. And as I said, Lilium candida, it is tolerant to low temperature. What Astromelia? It is also called Peruvian lily. Again, it was asked many times, and it was named in the honor of Carl von Astromer. It is believed that he gave the seeds of Astromelia pellegrina to the Carl Linnaeus, which is who is the father of Indian, which is the father of taxonomy. So because of that, it was named, Astromelia was named after him. And it is mostly grown in mid and high hills regions of regions. And dieted of horticulture Himachal Pradesh is putting an effort to promote this crop, and the propagation is through rhizomes. And there are important varieties like Aladdin and Mona Lisa, which was asked, and you can see other varieties later. And flowers are mostly stored at 4 degrees centigrade for 2 to 3 days. This is the picture of rhizomes. And there is one disorder which is called tulip finger. Astromelia, it is usually harvested by pulling the stems out of the plant. Usually all the flowers, we cut the stems, right? For Astromelia, we pull out the stems. And what happens is it exudes saps, and that saps causes irritations to the finger, and that is called tulip finger. Though the name is tulip, but it is related to the Astromelia. And thinning is very important operations in case of Astromelia. And thinning, it is also done for the flower regulation purpose. And these are two important species which is also used, which is also grown by some of the growers, that is Astromelia citacina and Astromelia hukeri. Now coming to Dahlia. Dahlia is also called as the king of flower, and it is said to be day neutral plant. And this is important. Agri Horticulture Society of India, it introduced Dahlia in the year 1957. And propagation, it is mostly done through terminal stem cutting. Yeah, like yesterday also I was telling, in case of Dahlia, what happens if we seed, propagate through seed, we do not get the homozygous plant. That's why to avoid the condition of heterozygosity, we usually go it through terminal stem cutting. And again, self incompatibility is a major problem in Dahlia. And this one natural mutant, that is mutant variety Junita, and powdery mildew is one of the important diseases in Dahlia. Now coming to marigold. Marigold is also called Rose of Indies, and origin place is Mexico. We have some of the important species. Tagetes erector, it is African marigold, and it is diploid. And Climax is the first hybrid of African marigold. And varieties developed by IARI New Delhi is Pusa Basanti Ganda, which is a sulfur yellow color, and Pusa Narangi Ganda is an orange color. Please remember its flower color, because I saw one questions in one of the exams where they had asked the flower color in this one. This is quite confusing to me. I don't know about you all. So please remember its color. And Pusa Bahar is a yellow color. Then Tagetes petula, it is a French marigold, and it is a tetraploid. It is a cross between Tagetes erata and Tagetes tenifolia. And Pusa orpica, it is again produced developed by IARI. It is an important variety of French marigold, and other varieties are here. You can go through it. And then there's one interspecific hybrid, that is Knockgate, and it is a triploid. It was developed in USA. And Pusa Shankar one, also important interspecific hybrid. Here I have mentioned the parentage for the red and gold hybrids and nuggets. These are the triplets, you can see it later. Pegetus tenifolia, it is also called single sydney. It is mostly grown in Western countries. What happened, like in India, we mostly grow African and French marigold, whereas in Western country, along with that, they even grow this single sydney also. It is also a diploid species. And as Sarif experienced, you have to remember like which are the diploid and triploid and tetraploid species and varieties. And Tegetus lucida, it is a sweet-scented marigold. And it is, IHR has developed two important varieties, Orca alancar, which is a yellow, and Orca ugly, orange color. And these are the receptacle-less flower variety. And other is Tegetus minuta, it is also called wild marigold. And it is mostly found in northwestern Himalayas, and it is used for production of essential oil. And as you all have seen in the farmers' field, like they grow marigold as a border crop. So it is because like it helps in reductions of the root knot nematode because of the presence of alpha-39 compound. And flower petals contains lutein 80 to 90%, and halenine is again a compound and that is used for eye adaptability. And lutein is also used in the egg yolks. We have gametophytic male sterility in case of Epetalus. Gametophytic male sterility is due to the nuclear genes. And Epetalus and double flower, two types of male sterility we can find in marigold. And in Epetalus, there will be no stems. In case of double flowers, it produces no anthers in the disflorate. Disflorate are usually absent in case of double flowers. And this GMS is controlled by single recessive gene. And seed rate, it is important, usually 1.5 kg per hectare. Then these are some of the varieties developed by NBRL Lucknow and PAU Ludhiana. These are for your reference. And through selections, BCKB, IHR and USF Noni has developed some of the lines. You can go through it later. And in case of marigold, this table is very important. The time of nursery raising, it's different for low heels, mid heels and high heels. So usually questions are asked from here. You please go through it repeatedly. You may tend to get confusion, so please do revise again and again. And spacing for African, French and dwarf marigold, and yields also. So it will be of no point even if I read it now, so you go it when you get time and do revision again and again. And again, damping of it is caused by Rajectonia solani, Pythium and Phytophthora. It is one of the one of the major problem during nursery raising in marigold. Some of the varieties developed by ICAR, IARI, Pusa Bahar, it is African marigold, and Pusa Alpita is it's a French marigold. And from ICAIHR, we have Orca Agni. It is orange color. It is photosensitive. It was developed through CMS. And the propagation is done through cuttings. Then cuttings, what happens if we go through, if we propagate through cuttings, we will be able to get the uniform flowering. French marigold, we have Orca Pari. This variety was released recently only. It is a bright orange, and Orca Honey, it is a bicolor and red bicolor, which is a combination of red and orange color, and this is photo insensitive actually. And it is an open pollinated variety. And we have some varieties from BCKB Kalyani, HAU Hisar and IHBT. These are some of the intravarietal cultivars. That's Climax, and like the cross between Alaska and Cupid Orange Mom. This was taken from one of the research paper. So this shows early flowering, and the cross between Catrine and Cupid Orange Mom, it shows good total number of flowers and all. You can go it later. These are the parents for the Pusa Basanti Genda and Pusa Narangigeta, and some of the its characteristics. You can see Pusa Narangigeta is orange color and Pusa Basanti Genda is yellow color. And these are some of the hybrids of Tegetus erecta, F1 hybrids of African marigold. Diamond Jubilee, Inca Yellow, Golden Jubilee, Golden Climax, Silver Jubilee. Now coming to Jasmine. It belongs to family Oleaceae, so it was asked many times, so you remember it. And Jasminum Samba Gundumala, it is a tetraploid, and Jasminum Primulinum, it is also tetraploid. Jasminum Primulinum, it gives yellow flower, and jasmine, it was derived from the Arabic word jasmin, and it is a perennial shrub. TNEU has developed techniques for the export of jasmine to the international market, like in Dubai and USA. And this technique has been patented. So what they do is jasmine, they either make strings or loose jasmine, they treat it with 4% boric acid. And they put it into either CFB box or thermocol, and sometimes they put a layer of ice packs and they send it to the foreign market. These are some of the species that gives yellow, white and pink color. You can go through it. Mostly SRF experience, you can remember these species. And here I have given some of the common name of the jasmine, its scientific name, where it was originated, pruning time, spacing and yield. You can go through it later. And this is again a very, very important table. So kindly go through it and revise it again and again. Seed viability for jasmine is usually 10 months. And 1 tons of fresh flower, it gives 2.8 to 3 kg of concrete. And some of the eminent breeders, I have seen in the past, like they have asked even the breeder's name also. There will be options will be given, and which of the following are eminent breeder like Dahlia or even jasmine and all. It is given in instant horticulture. So for some of the crops, you please go through that, and it will be asked in multiple questions. So for jasmine, eminent breeders are S. Muthuswamy, Madhava Rao, Bhupal Rao, and H.C. Srivastava. And quality jasmine perfume, it is produced from France, from the grass regions. And famous jasmine oil is produced from Spanish jasmine. And here are the some of the species, their self-life, concrete recovery, and concrete yield. You please go through it. And there's one variety from IHR, Orca Shurabi, which is a variety of Jasminum grandiflora. And Orca Aradhana is a variety of Jasminum sambar. And Orca Orpen is a variety of Jasminum multiflorum. Now coming to Crossandra. Crossandra is also called firecracker plant. And it belongs to family Acanthaceae, and it is originated from Indo-Malaya region. And what I want to request everybody, like the plants, whichever be it shrub, trees, or any of the cut flowers, or even loose flowers or minor flowers that is originated from India, please make a separate note for that. And in the past, the plants that which is originated from India has been asked many times. Crossandra, it is commercially cultivated in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Andhra Pradesh. And these southern states mostly occupies 15% of the area. Some of the cultivars are orange Crossandra, It is a tetraploid variety. Daily Cassandra, it is a triploid. Then UTI yellow, it is a tetraploid, and Scabulus red, again it is a tetraploid variety. Here are some of the pictures. And variety that is developed from IHR Bangalore is Arca Ambara and Arca Kanaka, Arca Srabya and Arca Shriya. For Arca Ambara and Arca Kanaka, please remember its flower color. Ambara is orange color and Arca Kanaka is yellow color. Now we'll talk about tuberose. Tuberose, it's also commonly called as Rajniganda. And it is originated in Mexico, and it is propagated through bulbs, and it should be at least minimum of 25 to 30 grams or 2 centimeter in diameter. And it is adapted, usually it is a tropical plant, but it is adapted to subtropical conditions also. You can see tuberose growing in Himachal Pradesh as well. So optimum temperature is 25 to 28 degrees centigrade, and this is the spike. Inflorescence is called spike, and it opens acropetally. That means the basal flowers open first, then it moves upward. There are some of the single varieties and double varieties. Single cultivars are mostly fragrant, more fragrant, and it is used for productions of essential oil. And it usually contains 0.08 to 0.1% of concrete. Although for different varieties, different concrete recovery is there. But in general, from single cultivars, we can produce this amount of concrete. And Rajat Rekha, Brazil Singer, Calcutta Singer, and Mexican Singer are the single cultivars. Use Calcutta Singer and Mexican Singer as name only suggest, so you will not be confused. Whereas Rajat Singer, Prajar and Singer, Prajar and Singer, Rajat Rekha, Prajar and Singer, they may ask whether it is a single cultivar or a double cultivar. Please remember this one. In single cultivar, what happens is usually we get a single row of the perianth, and in multi double flowers we have more than two rows of this perianth. And some of the double cultivars are Swarna Rekha, Subhashini, Vaibha, Arca Nirantara, Kolkata double, and Mexican double. Varieties developed from IHS Shringar. It is single. As you can see, we have only it has only single row of perianth. And Subhashini, it is a double, and Prajwal is single, and Vaibhav is double. Again, their parentage I have given. You can go through it. And from NBRA Lucknow, we have two very important cultivars, Rajat Rekha and Swarna Rekha. Again, I said Rajat Rekha is a single flower type, and it is a mutant of single Mexican single, and Swarna Rekha, it is a double flowered, and it is a mutant of his pearl double. Now coming to Trinaster. Trinaster, it is a half hardy annual. It has ray florate and disflorate. This is the disflorate and this is the ray florate. Disflorate are usually hermaphrodite, and ray florate are florates are pistillate. In terms of annual flowers, it ranks next to chrysanthemum and marigold. Seed rate is 2.5 to 3 kg, again very very important. And Aster Yellow, as my friend Parvati also mentioned yesterday, it is caused by phytoplasma, and the transmitter is yellow hopper, leaf hopper. It is a self-pollinated crop, Trinaster. Here we can find the Geitonogamous. Geitonogamous is in the single plant itself, one pollination of one flower may pollinate the other flower. What happens in Geitonogamous conditions? In the same plant, one flower from one flower may pollinate the other flower, but in the same plant. So it is a self-pollinated condition. This kind of conditions it is found in Trinaster. And pure yellow color is still not available in Trinaster yet. And it comes into blooming usually after 3.5 to 4 months of transplanting. Varieties developed from IHR, Kamini, Purnima, Shashank, Violet Cushion, Arca Aradhya, Arca Arjuna, white color. So there are some of the varieties in China as well that is produced, that is developed from NPKB rawweed. That is fully Ganesh pink, fully Ganesh yellow, and all, fully Ganesh purple, and all. You can go to their website. So this was all about the major cut flowers and the loose flowers. And as I have been seeing, sometimes they ask direct questions in terms of physiological disorders, though I have mentioned these disorders in respective PPTs also, but just to amalgamate into one table, I have put this table. You can go it through later. We have major physiological disorders in case of rose. We have bullhead due to the insufficient carbohydrates or even heart pruning and trips. This is the image of the bullhead, a physiological disorder. Even thrip infestations may lead to the bullhead conditions in rows. And we have bent neck. It is mostly a post-harvest disorder. It will be either due to the deficiency of water in the neck. I mean, like, water won't be able to reach it to the butt due to the vascular plugging. So that may lead to the bent neck. And we have blind shoot. It is usually bud aversion. We may not get flower in the stem, or even if it's there, then that is not marketable. And in terms of gladiolus, we have fluoride toxicity. So gladiolus is also called as a fluoride indicator plant. And fluoride indicator plant, and that is why gladiolus is usually not recommended to go for planting around the industrial areas. And we have again very important disorder in gladiolus, topal or bud rot, due to the deficiency of calcium. And we have geotropism. As I said yesterday also, it is due to the uneven distribution of auxin. As you know, auxin, it has a it travels in a bicipital fashion. So when its distribution is uneven, it leads to the geotropism. And geotropism, this condition is also found in other flower like Antirrhinum majus, which is also called snapdragon, and even in lupin also. That is why vertical transportations or vertical placement of this flower is very important. Then we have calyx splitting, as you can see here in the picture also. It is due to the low temperature. When the temperature is usually lesser than 10 degrees centigrade, that may lead to the calyx splitting. What happens is there will be growth of extra rolls inside the calyx. So that may lead to the splitting of it. And we have slab slide. That is like bud protrudes to the one side. And grassiness, it is mostly genetic. And sleepiness, it is due to the presence of high ethylene. Yes, yesterday also I said ethylene, it is a condition, it is a very ethylene sensitive. We have leaf scorch, bud blast, puffy foliage due to the frost injury. And in terms of orchid, we have sepal dry sepal injury, or deformed flowers or brown throat. And in case of Astromedia, we have chalking. It is mainly due to poor handling or storage in humid conditions, or even when bulbs are exposed to the sunlight. And there are some of the specialty flowers. Specialty flowers are the flowers that are having unique features, so that can be grown in the garden. There are many specialty flowers, but most of which this butter paradise and heliconia are important, because I have seen some of the questions from these two crop. So I thought I'll just put it here. Butter paradise, it is also called crane flower. Scientific name is Strelitzia resini. I have not mentioned, one can note it down. Strelitzia resini, and it belongs to family Strelitziaceae, and it is originated in South Africa, and its chromosome number is 14. It is mostly a herbaceous perennial plant, and pollination is done through bird, that is ornithophily. And there is one species, Strelitzia resini variety humilis. it is grown for the, it is suitable for container growing. And this actually what you see, this greenish part, it is a bud, and these are the flowers. And yeah, and yield, it usually gives after 3 years of planting, and it produces usually 1 to 3 spikes per plant. And storage, this is again a tropical flower, so storage temperature is quite higher than the other normal flowers. So storage, it can be, we can do it at 10 degrees centigrade for 4 days, and its base life is usually 7 to 8 days. Now we have this Heliconia. What you can see in the picture is Heliconia rostrata. Again, it has many species. Sorry, I was not, I couldn't put all the images. It is, it's Heliconia, it belongs to family Heliconaceae, and it is originated in Central and South America. It is also called lobster claw, parrot flower, parrot plantain, or false plantain. And in India, 50% of production of Heliconias come from the West Godavari district of Andhra Pradesh. So this much for Heliconia.
Ma'am, what is acropetale means?
Pardon?
Ma'am, acropetale means?
Acropetale. Did I mention that term?
Yes, ma'am, in tuberose.
Oh, acropetale means flowers, it opens from the basal side. The lowermost flowers, florets open first, then the next, like, then the uppermost florets open later.
Okay, ma'am. Thank
you. Got it?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Then what ma'am? Does single flower type and double flower type meaning in tuberose?
Pardon?
What does single flower type and double flower type meaning in tuberose?
In tuberose, we have the florets, right? Each floret, we have inflorescence, which is called spike. Then each spike, we have small florets, right? In that floret, if we have only single row of the perianth, only single row, if it's there, it is called single. And if it has more than two, then these are called double.
Okay, ma'am.
It depends upon the row of the perianths.
Ma'am? In terms of anthurium, you have mentioned that the storage temperature for anthurium is 13 degrees Celsius.
Yeah,
but yeah. In most books, it's written that its storage temperature is 14 to 17 degrees Celsius. Which one is correct?
Ma'am, it is 13 degrees centigrade, okay? In standard book, it has mentioned 13 degrees centigrade. So, because it is a tropical flower, so because, again, though it is a tropical flower, again, storing it more, again, higher conditions, higher temperature may lead to some of the blemishes, production of blemishes. In case of anthurium, usually that spade color, what we see, the red color, pinkish color and all, that will turn into different colors, okay, if we do not get the correct storage temperature. So in standard book, like commercial floriculture, it has mentioned 13 degrees centigrade. So 13 degrees centigrade is the correct answer. All right, again, more than that, it is usually not recommended.
Okay, ma'am. And ma'am, what are the color of the Arka Kanaka and Arka Ambara?
Arka Kanaka and Arka Ambara?
Color.
It is given in the PPT. Can you please see it later?
Okay, ma'am.
All right. So,
ma'am, in jasminum species, which yield high oil, ma'am? Grandiflorum or Auriculatum?
Highest yield is jasminum grandiflorum auriculatum, but best oil is produced from jasminum grandiflorum. You got it?
Okay, ma'am.
Highest from jasminum auriculatum, and best quality is from jasminum grandiflorum. And those concentrations, I think I have mentioned in percentage of the oil recovery, I think I have mentioned in PPT also. Even if it's not, then it is given in the instant you go through. And usually for the jasminum auriculatum and jasminum grandiflorum, for these three species, they usually ask in the exam.
Anthurium is Harma product, right?
Anthurium, only that candle what I show, no? Asparix, it has a hermaphrodite flower.
Okay.
The main flower it is present in the candle, that's Asparix. And what you see that red color, it is not exactly a true flower.
Fragrantless jasminum species, ma'am.
Pardon?
Fragrantless jasmine species.
Fragrantless.
Yeah.
Jasminum multiflorum. It is a fragrantless species.